Hi, welcome to Science Time at Questacon. My name's BJ.
And I'm Dion.
And today at Science Time, we're talking about our senses. Come and join us.
Wake up, sun and moon. It's science time. It's science time. Wake up, skeleton. It's science time. It's science time. At home, in the bathroom, when we're swimming, there is science. Outside, at the playground, in the sunshine, there is science. Wake up.
Welcome, welcome to Science Time, everyone. We're talking about our senses today. Now, our senses are what we use to find out about the world around us. For example, we see things. What do we use to see things with?
Binoculars.
Binoculars. You can use binoculars, can't you? What part of our body do we see things with? Do we look with?
Eyes.
Our eyes. Can you show me where your eyes are? Yeah. Where are your eyes? And we also hear things. What part of our body do we hear things with? With your ears. Can you show me where your ears are? Yeah, there your ears. Can you show me where your ears are? And we also smell. What part of our body do we use to smell? Our nose. Yeah, where's your nose? Now, we also taste with something. What do we use to taste? We taste our breakfast, don't we? With our tongue. Can you show me? Where's your tongue? Where's your tongue? We taste with our tongue. Well done. Now, we also touch with something. What part of our body do we use to touch with? Where are your fingers and your hands? Oh, we can also tickle with those too. Oh, we can touch with our hands.
I get tickled every single night. If I do a good job with my reading.
Oh, do you? Now, talking about touching, can you touch your head? Where's your head? Show me your head. Can you touch your shoulders? Whoop. Can you touch your knees? Whoop. Where are your knees? Where are your knees?
How about you say this? Knees and toes.
There's a song. We're going to go toes next, aren't we? And here are our toes. Can you touch your toes? Do you know a song about heads and shoulders, knees and toes? And in the middle, we also say eyes. Where are our eyes? Where are your eyes? And ears, and mouth, and nose. Are we ready to sing? Are we ready to sing? So start with our head. And grown-ups, I want everyone singing. Big voices, kids, and heads and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Heads and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes, and eyes and ears and mouth and nose. Heads and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes. Oh, well done, well done. Now, today I want to introduce you to a special friend of ours called Jane. Can we all say hi, Jane?
Hi, Jane.
Hi. But unfortunately, Jane can't hear you very well. What does she need to hear you with? Ears. So here we go. Let's get some ears for Jane. So there we go. We'll put on her ears.
No.
No? Where do your ears go? You show me. Oh, do they go there, do they? Can you show me where your ears? Where are your ears? Oh, on the side of our head. Okay. So we'll put one ear there and one ear there. There we go. Now Jane can hear, but she can't see very well. What does she use to see? Eyes. So here we go. Let's put her eyes on. One, two. Two eyes.
What?
Oh, do they? Okay. So here we go. So one there and one there. There we go. Is that better? Is that where they go? Yeah. Is that where they go?
Yeah.
Oh, a little bit there maybe? There we go. Not bad. So she has ears to hear, eyes to see, but she can't smell. What do you use to smell with? Your nose. And your nose goes between your eyes, doesn't it? So there we go. Perfect.
No?
No, it doesn't. Okay. There's that better? So she has ears to hear, eyes to see, nose to smell, but she can't taste anything. What do we use to taste with? Mouth. And what part of your mouth do you use? Your tongue. Your tongue. And Jane has a big tongue. So there we go. And is it there?
No, it's there.
There we go. So there's Jane and her big tasting tongue. So she can hear with her ears, see with her eyes, smell with her nose, and taste with her tongue. But she can't feel anything. What do we use? Hands. Now, our hands are on the end of our arms, aren't they? Where are your hands? Can you wiggle those fingers? Yeah. Now, Jane, she doesn't have any hands. So we're going to put her hands right here. And they can be her jazz hands. Can you show me your jazz hands? Oh, lovely. They're really on the end of your arms, aren't they? Yeah. So she's got ears to hear with. Where are your ears? She has eyes to see with. Where are your eyes? She has a nose to smell. Where's your nose? And she has a tongue to taste. Where's your tongue? And she has hands to feel with. So she's ready to have lots of fun at science time. Now, before we go and play, I've got a game I want to show you. This is a listening game. In this box, I've got lots of musical instruments. I'll lift them up and show them to you. Well done, sitting on your bottom. What instrument is this one called?
A maraca.
It's a maraca or a shaker. And listen to the sound it makes. That's a good noise, isn't it? And what instrument's this one?
A tutor.
A bit of a hooter. Well done. Oh, come and sit on your body, sweetheart.
I know how you do it.
And you hooter, don't you? Or we can call this a horn. Listen to the sound it makes. That's a noisy
you can
sound.
Put them on your bike.
You can put them on your bike. Here I come. And this instrument here, what one's this called? Looks like a horn. What's this one called?
A tambourine.
Listen to the sound of the tambourine. And last instrument today, what's this one called?
A bell.
A bell. Listen. Oh, that's nice. Now, I'm going to play all these instruments, but I'm going to hide them in here so we can't see them. We have to use our hearing to figure out what they are. So, you ready? Ready to be a good listener? Okay, so listening first. Let's just listen before we call out. Now, what do you think it is? Oh, what do you think? It's the tambourine! Well done! Did you think that too at home? Yep. Yeah. So we'll put that one there. Now, here's another one. Listening. Listen. Oh, it's the maraca! Did you know that one? Yeah! Now, don't peek! What's this one? Here, listening. That's a very loud sound, isn't it? And one more. Listen before we call out. Listen.
Bell.
A bell. Good listening. Oh, you're very good at the hearing game. Oh, that helps you hear. How were you? Did you know what those sounds were? Now, we've got lots of exciting things to play with here at Science Time today. Are you ready? Find your grown-ups and ready, set, go! Go have a play!
We're gonna learn about the world we live in. It's science time, it's science time. We're gonna play, it's fun experimenting. It's science time, it's science time. At home, in the kitchen, when we're cooking, there is science. Outside, in the garden, in the night sky, there is science. Wake up, sun and moon, it's science time, it's science time.
So while everyone's playing, come with me. I've got something exciting to show you in Questacon. So today we're here at Questacon's Perception Deception Gallery, here at our Ames room. Today we're going to be talking a little bit about illusions. Now, illusions make things look different to what they really are. You can have illusions that make things appear when they're not there, or you can even have illusions that make things look completely different to what they look like in real life. So for this experiment, we might need BJ's help today. So BJ, do you want to come give us a hand?
Ready on. Hi, boys and girls.
Now, if you look at BJ and I, who looks taller, do you think? I think it might be me, actually. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and change that using an illusion.
Fantastic.
You ready, BJ?
I'm ready.
Let's go. So, who looks taller now? I think I still look pretty tall. And BJ, you look really, really small.
I'm not really this small, Dion.
Well, how about we try switching and we'll see what happens. Oh, now who looks taller?
Me.
I think BJ does. And I look really, really short. I don't know if I like being this short, BJ.
I kind of like being this tall, though.
Well, I'm about ready for this illusion to be over. Let's go.
Let's go.
Well, that was a lot of fun. I'm glad we're back to normal, though. So let's go back to science time and see what we're up to.
I've got something I want to show you before we go today. Here, I've got two cards. I want you to look at these cards very closely and tell me which card looks bigger.
None of them.
Oh, hold on. I know you might know the truth. Which one looks bigger? You think that one? Who else? Hold on. Who else thinks this one looks bigger? It does, doesn't it? But now, watch closely what I'm going to do. I'm going to change them around. Now, which one looks bigger? This one looks bigger, does it? But that was the small one before. Here, watch again. I'm going to turn them back over, change places. Now, which one's bigger? This one. Do you know, this looks bigger, but they are in fact exactly the same size. You know this trick, don't you? This is a special science trick. Now, you are all going to get some of these to take home with you. And on our website at home, you can find these, you can print them off and cut them out, and you can play a science trick on someone at home. Now, today, we've also got other stuff to take home. We've got our information sheet. Now you can find these on our website as well. This is for our grown-ups talking about what we did at science time. Yep, and you can have a look, and also fun stuff that you can do at home. So Dion, can you go and give those to all our grown-ups? That would be great, thank you. And one other thing, look here. This is our colouring in sheet today. We're all going to get one, yeah. And this is also on our website at home. You can print it off and colour it in. Yeah, here we go. A picture for everyone. And now it's time to look at the boys and girls at home and say, see you next science time. Can we look at the boys and girls at home? See you next science time. Bye. Come and get a colouring in picture, everyone. Here we go.
Questacon Science Time is held at Questacon in Canberra, Tuesday to Friday during school terms. Bookings are essential. For further information, go to our website at questacon.edu.au. See you next Science Time.